In the Closet came at a time when it was necessary for Michael to assert his sexuality.
There were a lot of rumors that Michael Jackson was gay, was bisexual. You know, there he was trying to be sexy with Naomi Campbell while all these rumors are going on, and then the song is called Keep It in the Closet.
Photographer Herb Ritz co-directed the video and gave the raunchy romp its fashion spread flair.
I want Naomi right here and Michael working.
It was just more than the same. It was just a beautiful picture because, you know, Herb Ritz coming from a photography background, he's going to shoot pretty pictures, so it was just refreshing to see that. You get to see Naomi with very little on, that's always a plus.
Michael and Naomi's dirty dancing steamed up the screen, but off camera, Michael was a complete gentleman.
He was very sweet, he was very shy. And I would say, like, I'd say, bloody hell, and he'd say, don't swear, Naomi, stop cursing. I'd be like, sorry.
Keep it in the closet.
Despite its title, In the Closet was a bold attempt to show Michael's sexy side. But as TV viewers watched the King of Pop bump and grind, some critics said Michael didn't go far enough.
The one thing I was disappointed about the Keep It in the Closet video is you almost wanted to see him be more physical with Naomi. There was this great opportunity for them to just kind of be, you know, really sexy and get down. And she kind of does, but he kind of holds back.
While not everyone bought Michael's sexy new persona, In the Closet showed, as always, the King of Pop wasn't afraid to make a statement on screen.